So the first question is on your vision about the future of brain research, especially in human systems neuroscience, taking into account a timeline quite long, up to 2050.
Yeah. Thank you for this question. I think it's pretty difficult to really try to look around the corner so long time, like more than 40 years. So if I would look somehow backwards 40 years ago, it would be mid-70s, and I think much of the current progress of neuroscience would not have been predicted at that time. But I think it's very difficult to predict the future unless you try to shape it yourself. And that's, of course, what neuroscientists and scientists try to do. So basically, we are going very much along those lines that have been already worked upon. And so that means that part of that progress will be predictable. But there will be, all the time, there will be different type of discoveries that are, of course, unpredictable. And they can shape the field quite in a surprising manner. So that's something what I can say for sure, that there will be certainly surprises in the field before we are in 2050. But quite important is also that we can, or the scientific community and the society, they can boost these discoveries by putting funding to certain areas and putting and encouraging scientists to really be interested in certain topics. So although these discoveries, they are unpredictable, so maybe at this like statistical level, some discoveries and innovations, they are something that are more like unavoidable.
If you could give some examples of discoveries that, fields, some fields in which we are on the brink of a big discovery.
Yeah, I think that's one is that certainly it's like in my field is this constant development of brain imaging. And there will be certainly during the next decades, there will be increasing information about, for example, about the maps of and the structure and also functional maps of the human brain. And especially the connectivity between different brain regions and how the environment and all experience shape them. So that's one thing. And then, of course, brain has several spatial and temporal scales in which it functions. Like if we think about the time scales, they go from under milliseconds, which is 1,000th part of a second, up to several decades, like the whole human age. And then we have to somehow try to bridge these different levels. That's one thing. And then, of course, we try to understand as a community all the brain circuitries that support these cognitive functions and what could be wrong when the people get different brain diseases. So that's something that which will certainly happen. But then, of course, several new discoveries, like I hope there will be treatments in 2050, at least one of the very important neuropsychiatric diseases, which is either schizophrenia, depression, autism, and that kind of diseases, or dementia. And then we would develop more biomarkers to diseases. So that would tell us already in advance that some people are at risk in getting some diseases, so that the treatment or rehabilitation could be started earlier. And that also this could be used also as a follow-up of these diseases. Mm. And maybe there will be also some good recipes for good aging of the human brain, so that there will be better advice is how we could keep our brains in shape even to the old age, as the in general the population is aging very, very rapidly.
Yeah, I see. And also I think about brain regeneration after a stroke or after an accident.
Yeah, sure. Then it's less, if I think about it like working conditions, I think the working culture of neuroscientists, at least in our field, it will certainly change that so that the focus will go to interdisciplinary teams. And there have been, until now, there's been much discussion about interdisciplinarity, but now we should go to the somehow to the next level, that not only we would have interdisciplinary teams, but we would have people, scientists, who are interdisciplinary themselves.
Yeah.
So they would cover more than one field, at least the basics of them, so that they could then communicate very fluently with others. But that, of course, will then need lots of changes in education of young scientists. So we have to consider this type of change in the culture.